Hi, my name is Karen Lang. I'm a curriculum developer for Technovation, and I'll be leading you through some of these tutorials and videos, so I wanted to introduce myself. I used to be a computer science teacher, and I taught kids just like you how to code for many years. After that, I worked with the MIT App Inventor team, making tutorials, writing curriculum, and running workshops to teach people how to make mobile apps using App Inventor. I'm now part of the Technovation team, hopefully helping you on your journey to make an incredible mobile app or AI project. So let's get started. First, go to the website machinelearningforkids.co.uk.
When you get to the Machine Learning for Kids website, you would click on the Get Started button. And there's a few options here. The best option is to be able to log in. That will enable you to have an account and you can save projects and return to them. However, in order to do this, you're going to need a teacher or an adult to sign up for you, and then they would create a student account for you. The way it works is a teacher or an after-school organizer would sign up and then create accounts for all their students. However, if you're working on your own, you can do this try it now. Trying it now is great, and if you're just trying this out to experiment, it's a great option. The one thing is that you won't be able to save the project and return to it. You'll have to do all the work all at once and then try it out. Just come here and click on Add New Project. If you are using an account that your teacher has set up, then you would just click on Add New Project as well. I already have a couple of projects here, but I'm going to add my new one. Add a name, and for this one, we're going to call it Make Me Happy. And recognizing, what are we recognizing? So it's going to be text, images, numbers, or sound. So we want to recognize text. So the user is going to be typing in either happy or sad phrases or sentences, and we want our AI to recognize that. The language, I'm going to choose English, but there is a drop-down list of different languages, so you can choose which language you'd like, and I'm going to create. Okay, so now I've got my new project. I'm going to click on it to open it up. You see we have three different steps here to creating our project. So we're going to train our AI to recognize happy or sad sentences. Our AI will then learn based on the phrases that we add as our data set. And then we'll test it to make sure that it works. And then the third part we're going to make a scratch project to use our AI model that we've trained. We're going to go directly into Scratch, and we're going to make a project that reacts to sentences but not using AI, and we're going to see what the difference is. So let's go to Make. And we want to go to Scratch 3. So there's a couple of versions of Scratch here. We also have Python or App Inventor, but we're going to use Scratch 3. It tells us our project isn't ready yet, but we're going to use Scratch by itself. Okay, so now we're in Scratch. What we're going to do is we're going to make a very simple program that reacts to a nice or happy sentence input by the user or a sad one. The first thing we're going to do is change our sprite. We're not going to use the cat. So we're going to go up here to Costumes. And let's get rid of that cat. You can't get rid of all the costumes. You have to at least have one costume. So let's first go down to the bottom here left. Choose a costume, click on the paintbrush. We want to make a smiley face. So we want to do a circle. I'm going to change my filling to yellow. I'm going to do kind of your standard yellow face, smiley face. I might change this to 2 so it's not quite as big of an outline. Then I want to do another circle for the eyes. So I'm going to make mine just plain black. So I will drag over one and do a second. Hopefully I'll get them the same size. Okay, so I've got my standard face, which is just the two eyes. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to duplicate this. So if I right click over here on the left and click duplicate, I'll get a second one, and I'm going to duplicate it one more time. Now that I've got the three options, I'm going to get rid of the cat. So let's go to the first one. This is going to be my neutral face, or the one that's neither happy nor sad. So I'm going to go up here and change the name and say not sure. So that's the name of this costume. And I'm just going to have a straight face. So neither happy nor sad. Click on the second one. Let's make this the happy face. So I'll name this happy. And I'll use the paintbrush. I'm going to probably do this something like a width of 4. And I will make a happy face. Now I'm going to go down here to my last one. I'll change this one to sad. And again, I'm going to make a sad face. So I'll make a very sad face. And then maybe I'll do something like make a little teardrop coming from the eye. Really a sad face. Okay, so you can go ahead and make those three faces. So we've got neutral, not sure, happy, and we've got sad. Now that we've got our three faces, let's click on the first one because that's going to be our starting face. Then let's go up here and click on code, the top left. We're going to start with control, and we want when green flag is clicked, and that's going to start the project. So we've got our when green flag is clicked, and we want our project to always start with that not sure costume. So let's go to looks, so that's over here on the left, the purple, and drag over a switch costume too, and we're going to choose in the drop-down not sure. So every time we click the green flag, we'll start off with this not sure costume. What we want to do then is to ask the user to type in a message, and it's going to either be a happy message or a sad message. That will be under the sensing drawer over here, the light blue or cyan color. So under sensing, we want to drag in and ask this what's your name and weight. It defaults to what's your name, but we're going to change the question to say, type me a message. And wait. So this will stop, ask the question, and wait until the user responds. When the user responds, it will go into this answer, which is like a variable, but it's going to hold their answer. Once we get the answer from them, we want to check if they told us a happy message or a sad message. So we're going to go back to control and grab an if-then block. So an if-then block lets us test if something is true or not. So we want to test, is the answer they've typed in a happy message or a sad message? We're going to go over to the green operators blocks, and we're going to pull out an equal, which is one of these shaped blocks. Notice that the shape fits perfectly into the if. And we can test if something equals something else. So what do we want to test? We want to test, go back into sensing, if the answer they typed in, if they've typed in a message that's happy. So let's say, what would be a happy message? I think you are awesome. If they've typed that, we want to make a happy face. So let's go back to looks and to the costumes, and we're going to do a switch costume. And this time we're going to switch it to happy. Now that we've got happy taken care of, we want to do the same thing for sad. So let's go back to control, grab another if, operators, grab another equal, go back to sensing, grab answer. And this time we might say, what would make us sad? I don't like you very much. That would make me sad if someone said that. If the answer is, I don't like you very much, then we're going to go back to looks and change our costume again. And this time it will be sad. So now what we want to do is test this out. To test it out, We're going to press the green flag up here. To see this full screen, we can just click this button up here in the corner, full screen control. And it says, type me a message. So I think you are awesome. Happy face. Okay, that one worked. So let's try the green flag again. Notice that it resets it to the not sure face. Ask me to type a message. I don't like you very much. Sad face. That seems to work. Now let's try a different sentence. I love you. That would make me happy, but it doesn't change. Let's try a sad one. Even if I say I do not like you very much, which is very similar to I don't like you very much, it doesn't change. Going back to our code, it's very exact. We are only covering two possibilities. I think you are awesome, or I don't like you very much. And what we want is to be able to put in a variety of sentences, both happy and sad, and have the sprite react. And so that's where AI comes in. So what we need to do is to train our AI with our data set of happy and sad sentences so that it will recognize this and work for more cases than we currently have, because this is a very limited thing. So we're going to go back to our project and we're going to train our AI with our data set. Before we go back to our project in the Machine Learning for Kids website, we want to make sure to save our Scratch project. Sometimes it can get lost switching back and forth, so let's just make sure and go to the File menu and Save to your computer. And then just save your project. I've got it saved to my Downloads folder. It should save it somewhere on your computer, so just make sure it will be a scratchproject.sb3. I'm going to rename mine Make Me Happy. And remember that it's a .sb3, which is a Scratch project. Make sure to save that before you return to your Machine Learning for Kids, okay?